The sky is the limit is a phrase we often hear in motivational speeches. For SpaceX and Elon Musk, though, the vast and endless reaches of space are the true limits. You will see exactly how ambitious SpaceX has become recently. Welcome, dear viewers. We will take a look into SpaceX's highly ambitious plans to catch its booster rockets that deliver spacecraft into outer space during regular launch procedures. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe to Futurephile to watch more fascinating videos on futuristic tech. SpaceX's Super Heavy launch vehicle falls under the technical category of rocket launch vehicles, known as the Super Heavy Lift Launch Vehicle, SHLLV. These are capable of lifting more than 50 tons of various kinds of payloads into low Earth orbit as a minimal standard. These were some of the earliest rocket designs that were developed during the early stages of the space race. Notable examples include Saturn V, Energia, and most famously, the rocket launch system used to launch NASA's vaunted space shuttle up into low Earth orbit. The space shuttle was the first instance of any form of rocket reusability being possible, as it was partially reusable. This would later inspire SpaceX and prove that reusable rockets are indeed a real possibility. Elon Musk had initially expressed a wish to make the Super Heavy booster rocket fully reusable during the very early stages of its development, back when it was known as the BFR, or Big Falcon Rocket. This early name is a reference to SpaceX's previous Falcon rockets, in that the new rocket is essentially a much bigger Falcon rocket. BFR design underwent various design revisions over the years and months in line with a few objectives. These objectives included mass savings, cost savings, ease of use, and finally reusability. Achieving reusability was the ultimate prize, and achieving it meant that mass and costs would all come down significantly as well. Being the ultimate prize in the design process, it also meant that achieving it was incredibly difficult. SpaceX's standard launch procedures already includes recovering and reusing the first stages of its Falcon Heavy rockets. Already a shining achievement, these rocket boosters softly touch down vertically after about 9 minutes, following liftoff on the launch pad itself. Elon Musk wants SpaceX to one-up themselves and do even better, something never even conceived of before in rocketry circles. With the in-development Starship design, SpaceX is aiming to one day be able to bring the entire rocket booster down safely for reuse, just the same way as the Falcon rockets, by controlled and soft landings. The main motivations behind this development effort is to further reduce cost and body mass of the rocket. These issues have always been at the forefront of efforts to make rocketry even cheaper, paving the way for regularized space travel in the future. As a result, Elon Musk can bring himself and the rest of the world closer to dreams such as the colonization of the Moon and Mars. Efforts are already underway to make SpaceX's new spacecraft design, the Starship, fully reusable. It would make sense to ideally combine this reusability with the total reusability of the booster rocket that initially propels it upwards. Indeed, SpaceX will spare nothing in their quest to make both Starship and the Super Heavy booster it relies on fully and rapidly reusable. As of right now, SpaceX rockets have always landed by deployment legs all around the rocket as it returned to Earth. Given their commitment to making heavy mass cuts that would make catching the boosters any form of sense, future SpaceX spacecraft will not have any legs at all. While Elon Musk did explicitly mention in a Twitter post that they will try to catch the Super Heavy booster with the launch tower arm, any images of a separate device going up to actually catch it is unlikely. What is more plausible is that the rocket will be guided by its grid fins to align it in such a way as to allow it to interlink with the launch arm. There is no indication that the launch arm itself or another vehicle or device would be used to break the fast descent of Super Heavy or control it. Speaking of the grid fins, it would seem that the Super Heavy will continue to use its own engines to control its descent slowly, as the Falcon 9 already does. Grid fins may see some sort of redesign or strengthening of the frame with better and more stress-resistant and stronger materials to allow such an impressive landing maneuver. Seeing as how SpaceX only hires the best scientific and technical talent available in the job market from different countries around the world, it makes sense that only SpaceX is capable of such a feat. This development is crucial for SpaceX if they want to continue to maintain their lead in the current space race. We know for a fact that SpaceX's competition have all been lining their rifles up to take aim against them. with many new projects from Virgin Galactic and other companies who have been taking up vested interests in cementing their place in the new space race. The everlasting challenge is being able to continually drive down the costs of rocketry and space travel, and the laser-guided focus with which SpaceX has been advancing towards that goal is indicative of the company's spirits and determination to not be undone. One could easily see how a resounding success in being able to catch Super Heavy, as Elon Musk describes, will greatly help SpaceX and the industry as a whole. The process can lead to SpaceX's efforts in their other projects, such as commercial space trips and the Starlink project, being made much easier. Competitors will surely enough pick up their part of their slack and develop their own reusable rocket system. Elon Musk has a gifted ability to balance his own company's advances and competitiveness in the market and the benefits of the industry as a whole. If the entire industry benefits from technological breakthroughs previously unanticipated, the customers and humanity as a whole also benefits. Tesla had previously publicized their car battery system patent for use by other car companies. Elon Musk clearly stated his company's philanthropic aims in making the patent public. It is hard to tell whether SpaceX will file a successful full rocket recovery program, such as this, as a patent, or whether it qualifies as a patent at all. What can be confirmed is that if SpaceX achieves what they are looking to achieve, they might just be all the more happy to share it with their allies and contractors in the space industry, such as NASA. Many industry experts, critics, and laymen were understandably perplexed and skeptical of the very ambitious goals SpaceX continuously kept presenting for themselves throughout the years and beyond. Elon Musk has been continually silencing critics and skeptics throughout the years with all of his ventures. Very few people had confidence in Tesla's ability to make an electric vehicle that could compete with traditional combustion engine cars until they built the Tesla Model 3. Very few people had confidence in SpaceX's ability to be able to even begin reducing the astronomical costs involved in sending a rocket out into outer space until they built the Falcon rockets. They have recently silenced critics yet again with the successful test string of their new Starship design, of which the Super Heavy booster is a part. Similar initial successes with the Starlink internet project continue to prove that Elon Musk's company will always stay ahead of their respective games. If and when the procedurally sensitive and precise plans to catch the rocket, as Elon Musk describes, succeeds, the benefits reaped from it by SpaceX will greatly speed up their efforts in their other big project, Starlink. Starlink plans include sending up a total of more than 12,000 satellites up into orbit. This requirement, combined with Elon Musk's statement that he wants a Starship spacecraft carrying payloads up into space every week, means that success in catching the rocket as it descends is absolutely crucial for all of SpaceX's future plans. In the off chance that SpaceX is unable to make this venture a success, it should not negatively impact our high estimation of the company. They are attempting what the best and brightest scientists of the world superpowers, USA, Russia, and China, have failed to accomplish fully so far. In this regard, they are very close to success, but the stakes remain as high as ever. We earnestly wish SpaceX and Elon Musk all the possible success. That will be all for today's video, our dear viewers. Let us know what you think of the amazingly ambitious plan to catch the rockets as it descends. A true revolution in the drive to make space travel accessible to all. Do you think they can succeed in this drive and go on to benefit the rest of the industry and humanity? Or do you think SpaceX may face their first major setback given how difficult this achievement is going to be? If you like this video, you may also enjoy our full playlist on Tesla that is shown in the end screen. And please subscribe to Futurephile to watch more fascinating videos on futuristic tech.